Over the course of the past year, BBC Buzz has featured a wealth of young people who've inspired us with their achievements, their ambitions, and their innovations. We've met environmentalists who want to help preserve the planet by protecting a very special part of it. Down in the Sundarbans, we encountered Rubaiyat Mansoor Mowgli, who's part of a team working to protect the unique dolphin population off the coast of Bangladesh.
আপনি যখন একটা নদীর মোহনায় দুই জাতের ডলফিনকেই একটা এলাকার ভিতর দেখতে পাচ্ছেন, যে ইরাবতী এবং সুসুকেরা কিভাবে লাভ দিচ্ছে, বা সাগরের ডলফিন যখন দেখতে পাচ্ছেন অনেকগুলো এক দলে আছে, ওটার যে আনন্দটা, এই আনন্দটা যাতে আমাদের পরের জেনারেশন পায়, শুধুমাত্র এটার কথা চিন্তা করলেই তো এদেরকে সংরক্ষণ করা দরকার।
Meanwhile, 400 kilometers away in Gaibandha, an enterprising young man, 23-year-old Ahmedullah, was thinking about how to preserve the bird population of Bangladesh.
আমি লক্ষ্য করেছি যে পাখির বাসা সংকটের কারণে পাখিরা কমে যাচ্ছে। 2001 সালে মাটির কলস আমি দেখে ভাবলাম যে এখানেও হয়তো পাখি বাসা বাঁধতে পারে। তো এখান থেকে আমার মাথায় আসলো যে আমি মাটির কলস গাছে বেঁধে দেব।
Ahmed is now expanding his bird preserving initiative with a plan to plant hundreds of trees popular with nesting birds. While some of the people we featured were busy saving the planet, others were pushing different kinds of boundaries. We met Bangladesh's first female train driver, Salma Khatun, who was flying the flag for women undertaking traditionally male jobs. And on the contemporary music scene, we met Rita, one of the country's few female DJs.
যখন আমি ডিজে হতে চাচ্ছি, তখন আমার কাছে ফিল হলো কি আমাদের এখানে মেয়েদের জন্য কত লেস অপশন আছে। But if you really want to do something, prove them, you know, yeah, you are capable of doing that.
We caught up with educational pioneer Abul Hasnat Rizwan, whose innovative educational project has already won him acclaim from the likes of Bill Gates and Prince Charles. Rizwan is now planning to expand his riverboat schools with a new farming technique to help areas prone to flooding. And we hung out with university students Bikash and Fahad, who had started the country's first ever campus radio station. While some of our everyday heroes were experimenting with new culture and technology, others were busy preserving traditional culture. We met folk collector Simon Zakaria and metal crafter Shukanta Bonik. And we filmed an exclusive performance by the country's only professional mime troupe, Natua. Elsewhere, we discovered a whole generation of people bringing new forms of performance to Bangladesh. Naveed Mahbub had established Bangladesh's first ever stand-up comedy club, while magician Max Mistel had brought a new kind of magic to the streets of Dhaka. And on the dance scene, Adnan Saqib was spreading his love for salsa.
So, ami asha korbo in the future it will become more popular, and amar ultimate dream hobe je Bangladesh theke couple ra bideshi international salsa competition e participate korbe and they will win the competition.
We also went in search of our own bright young things with the BBC Buzz photo competition. For the winners who had their work exhibited at the world famous Drick Gallery, it was a dream come true.
I'm feeling honored এটার জন্য যে আমি এখানে আমার ছবি সিলেক্ট হয়েছে এবং এটা দ্রিকে এক্সিবিট হচ্ছে।
আসলে ভবিষ্যৎ পরিকল্পনা আসলে ভালো ছবি তোলা, খুব সাথ মনের মতো ছবি আসলে বেরোয়নি, ভালো ছবি তুলতে চাই।
And for others, it was just the beginning. Many of our finalists are now exhibiting professionally, including our Series 1 champion Nozrul Islam, whose winning buzz photo recently took top prize at a competition in Japan. A role on an international stage was to be on the cards for many of our featured sporting heroes too. Last year, we met archer Imdadul Haq Milon, who has since become the first Bangladeshi ever to qualify in archery for the Youth Olympics in Singapore, where he came seventh in the world. In the world of golf, we met Siddiqur Rahman, who in August this year took the title at the Brunei Open Golf Trophy, winning $48,000. This makes him the highest earning prize winner in Bangladesh's sporting history. And then there was our hotshot young surfer, Zafar Alam, who featured on one of our very first episodes of BBC Buzz. Zafar recently organized an international surfing competition at Cox's Bazar, which attracted over 100 competitors. Over the last year, we've also followed the days and the lives of a wealth of interesting professionals, from advertising executives and lawyers to pilots and policemen. We've got to know the private passions of some of the country's most popular celebrities and heard music from some of Bangladesh's best up-and-coming bands. We set out to find the best of everyday life in Bangladesh, and in doing so, have met some truly inspirational young people from all over the country. Thanks to them for letting us into their lives, for sharing their stories, and for showing us that there are so many different ways to achieve success.